The Rahu, Ketu and all that, you have to understand they are like clerks in a department. Okay? These Navagrahas that we are talking about, they are clerks. What does the clerk, so supposing you go to the clerk, sir, I have to put this application, I have to get this done, etc. The clerk tells you the process. You have to do this, you have to do this. Then also in India, they ask for more money for telling you the process. Okay? So, once that process is laid out, now the application goes to the higher authority. And then the higher authority will say, okay, application granted, right? That's what they say. Now imagine if you have access to directly the head of the department. Do you have to go to the clerk? Or even if your application is not properly filled, the guy higher authority says, hey, this is okay, I know this guy, I trust him, please grant the thing. What? The guy has to obey, no? All these Navagrahas we are talking about, all these gods and demigods and all these things that we are talking about, for normal people who don't have access to the higher light, they have to go through this process. Cut all that process off, directly go into Sanctum Sanctorium and have access to the Divine Enlightened One. When you have the Anugraha of Bhagavan, the Agraha of Navagraha won't even matter. Okay? There's a lot of Sanskrit there. When you have the grace of the Supreme Enlightened One, the anger of all these different planets, the nine planets, won't even matter. So why I'm saying, it's not that this is what, she gave a paradoxical statement. She said, even for the unenlightened one, all these are under access. No, that's not a true statement. The fact that they're unenlightened means that they don't use the access. They haven't realized it. But if you realized it, then the access will automatically come. Now, you all understand, all this potency is put in each individual, in each and every one, equally. And that's the question we have to ask, then why do I get indulged in rest of all of the stuff without not focusing on what the supreme access that is given to me, including username and password. The username is love all, the password is serve all. That's it. You get into that enlightenment. But we are still waiting. I don't know the username password. Forgot password. The forgot password is, then it's the username. If you love all, the password is sarval. Hrishchate lakshmishchapatnyo. When that is the motto, then what happens? The entire creation is abundant right there. Lakshmi, Hri, they're all. Then the next one is Hishchate Lakshmishchapatnyo Aho Ratre Parshve. Parshva means the sides. Aho Ratre Parshve. Now I am describing the meaning of the mantra, not is described in textbooks, which is all this is imposed upon God. Oh, for you, Bhudevi, Lakshmi Devi, there your consorts present there. Aho Ratre Parshve, your sides are. Who are you describing? Somebody else. Don't describe somebody else. Realize you are the realized one. Then what happened? Hri and Shri are with you. They're right in your heart. Right? So, again I said, love is Lakshmi Devi, serve is Bhudevi. You understand? That's what, because the mother, Bhudevi, she's always serving. She's always giving. She's always giving. And Lakshmi Devi is, she does it with love. Combine it with love. Not simply giving, but doing it with love. See, when you have love all, serve all as your consorts, then what happened? Aho ratre parshve, day and night are right by the side of. That means what? There is no time barrier. You are infinite. You don't say, I will only come to Sai Center if it is morning 9 o'clock, otherwise I won't come. Or I will do only Swami's project if I have time for it. Or you won't say all these excuses of time, because time becomes your control. You don't get controlled by time. Aho ratre parshve nakshatrani rupam. Then what happened? The infinite light nakshatrani becomes your form. Means what? Unimaginable. Where are the stars? That's how beyond the space you have become. Beyond the time we have become. Beyond the time, beyond the limitations of resources we have become. Hrishchate is Hrishri is resources. Then Time is another constraint beyond time. Nakshatrani Rupam means what? No space barrier, no time barrier, no space barrier, no resource barrier. Ashvinau Vyattam. Ashvini means basically in this context auspiciousness of health, bodily health. Ashvinau Vyattam means you open the mouth, it becomes a healing of somebody else. See how powerful the mantras are. How incredible. How powerful it is. When you speak to somebody, they get healed. That's what it is saying. Doesn't have to do anything. Just look at someone, they get healed. Just speak to someone, they get healed. That's the power that is given to the enlightened one. The enlightened one operates with abundance. The enlightened one operates without any limitation of time. The enlightened one operates without any limitation of space. Whatever they say is a healing of the entire universe. Just when they say it, it is the truth. Not truth is what they say. When they say it, it becomes truth. When Swami says, you all know, you heard the story of Sundaraya, no? He got bit by a cobra. When he got bit by a cobra, there was all drama that happened. You should all listen to this beautiful story that he shares. And then the person runs to Swami and they were finding the cobra anti-venom and all that stuff. A few months passed. He was fine. He was expecting Swami to come and take, ask him, how did you do with the cobra bite? Swami never even came and asked. He didn't even care what happened to him. He went through all this stuff. And then one day Swami was sitting in the chair and he was calling all the students and going. And then he comes to take Swami's namaskar. Swami looks at his foot and he says, what is that scar on that foot? Then Swami says, Sundar says, I'm sharing his entire story here, which is why I'm sharing this story specifically is Ashvinau Vyattam. Whatever they say is the healing power. And that's the reason why I'm mentioning this story. When he looks at the scar on his foot and he says, what is that scar? And then Swami, cobra hit me and all this. Cobra, no, just a thorn. You're lying, he said. It was just a thorn, Swami said. And then he was surprised. What, is Swami lying to me? Why is Swami lying to me? I got hit by a cobra. Why is Swami saying it is thorn? In that context, what is happening? Swami is, to this individual who experienced the cobra bite, Swami is lying. But the power is this. When he is walking out and he was at the doorstep, Swami calls him, hey, look around. So he looks around. When I say it is a thorn, it is a thorn. If Swami said it was a cobra, that fellow would have been dead right there. To protect you, I said, Ashvinau Vyattam. I said it is a thorn and therefore your life got saved. If I said it was a cobra, you were gone. Now you have to understand what is the power of the one that is talking to you. Never question the word of the divine one, the enlightened one when they are speaking. They said something to save your karma. They have no agenda beyond that. So you go talk to someone, they say something, you have no clue what they're talking. To your context, they're saying, what is they talking? It doesn't make any sense. You're analyzing, you're paralyzing. Know who you're talking to, Ashvinau Vyattam. When that happens, what? Ishtam Manishana, they will give you whatever you desire. Amum Manishana, beyond what you desire, sarvam manishana, everything that is required. So brothers and sisters, I know I'm going into the SSC time frame now, but the power of knowing the suktams like this is bestowed to the only ones that deserve it, is bestowed to the ones that need to be knowing the supreme truth, is bestowed because of the infinite grace of the Supreme Bhagavan. People have to ask the question, the power is given to me, I got all the keys for it, I am sitting on a jewel chest, but yet I am going around begging for food. All these mantras of divine knowledge of the Supreme Self are encapsulated in this beautiful Suktam, means the one that is said very beautifully. Ukti means to say. Sukti means to say it so profoundly, so encryptedly. So next time, next week, when we are celebrating the Krishna Janmashtami, we will start the offering with this beautiful Suktam, which completed right before Krishna Janmashtami, and we'll offer it to Sai Krishna, and then we will start Durga Suktam in September. Okay? Jai Sai Ram. Let's close with Om and Tri Shanti and Gayatri Mantra. Om. Shanti, Shanti, Shanti.